Welcome to this video where I would like to demonstrate you a Polycom group series in a Skype for Business environment. So in the back I got a group series 500, two screens, left screen configured for the participants and the right screen configured for presentation. So in front of me I got the Real Presence Touch. This is the new touch panel from Polycom. I will show you adding the participants, link clients into a call, and to show you the experience on the group series. So first of all, we go to the touch panel. Very easy and simple. Place a call. So what you do here, and because I have a recent call list, dialed to some clients before, let's find the Amsterdam OS1 right here. Call it right now. So we see also here the link client ringing. Let's pick it up. Let's make sure I mute it because we're all in the same room. So now I got a point-to-point call between group series and here my link client. And from the group series side you see the link client video. Now let's add another participant. It's very easy. We go here to add. So we'll find here the other context. So for example, the OS2. We're dialing the other link client. So you see here the link client is running. Let's make sure I mute the sound because that's everything is in the same room. Okay, so you see here the video from the other link client and from the group series. All are now in the call. And this is, by the way, a Skype for Business client, but it doesn't matter. You can use 2013 or Skype for Business client. It's all compatible. So see here what happens on the group series. You see now the active speaker person in the bigger picture and all other participants are placed around the group series. Now let's add some more link clients, Skype for Business clients. So here you go, you got now the multiple participant into the Skype for Business call. So this is all hosted on the Microsoft Link AVMCU server, or the Skype for Business server, and everybody is visible. So I think this is very powerful. So as I configure the left screen showing all the participants, it will be placed on that screen. You could use both screens if you want to divide them over two screens, but the right screen is now only for the presentation. So now let's say, for example, I want to remove a participant, so you can show here an overview of the participants. So you can see a link client, a group series, a link client. These are all integrated with the Skype for Business environment. But you can also remove, for example, a link client or a participant. So you can unmute it or remove. So see what happens on a group series if I remove it. So now I'm removing, for example, the convene unit. So automatically the screen will be placed as optimal as possible. It's all automatically done by the system. So the active speaker again is on the bigger picture and the rest will be placed around that. So now let's show you the last part, and that is sharing content. So I got here my Skype for Business client with all the participants. Let's say I want to share my desktop. So you could go here, presentation mode, and go into share desktop present. So on the other Skype for Business clients, you will see the presentation. I got also here a link 2013 client, which will also show you the presentation. Including, you see on the group series, natively receiving in 1080p resolution. If you allow that on the Skype for Business or on the link server, you receive the content here. So without any infrastructure, without any additionals, you got here Group Series and the Real Presence Touch integrated with the environment. The last point I wanted to show you here, when you're sharing content, you could drive the content on the Group Series. So let's say there is, for example, there is a mouse here in this room, and this is a wireless mouse, which is plugged into the USB of the Group Series. I'm able to drive this content. So let me show you. So on the Link client, you have the possibility, or Skype for Business, the possibility to give control. So I could give control here to the different persons or rooms. So let's say I wanna give control to the Amsterdam Group Series. So I shared here a presentation to show you what is possible. So on the Group Series side, I connected the mouse. I gave control to the Group Series. And now let me show you. From the mouse, you can see here my mouse. I can just click, for example, this picture and move it around. So I can move it down if I want, move it up. Just show you what is possible. So you could even, if you add a keyboard, you could even play with that. But also, let's say I'm in this room, you would like to drive the presentation, you could also do that. So I'm able to drive this presentation from the room and see what exactly you wanted to see. So here I'm browsing with my mouse through the presentation. Very easy. You can click on it and browse it. So I can give control to this room and drive the presentation. So this is something which is also part of the latest Group Series release. So thank you for watching this video. Hopefully it was helpful, and looking forward to the next video.